Good evening, Jubilee.
Carry
like a fight of all his love. We are moving all over the earth, that is his glory. You're moving over the earth like a fight of all his love. We are moving all over the earth, that is his glory.
I've been grafted to the vine.
are my beloveds. He is mine. I've been crucified with the Christ. I no longer live.
Tuning's always really awkward.
Like a child, I come again, for I can never tire of your presence. Like a child, I come again, for I can never tire of your presence. So take all of all of me like you. Take all of me again. And make all child, I come again, for I can never tire of your presence. Like a child, I come again. For I can never tire of your presence. So take all of me again. And make all.
We were born to adore.
cascades over my soul. It purifies me, purifies my heart. Wash over my soul. Make me whole. You wash over my soul. Man.
open up my heart and let you in. How sweet is your love? Sweet is your love. And how sweet is your love, Lord? Oh, how sweet is your love? How sweet is your love? Oh, how sweet is your love.
sweet is your love, my Father. Thank you. your presence. And I love, I love. And I love your presence. And I love, I love. And I love you, Jesus.
Become completely mesmerized. We're captured. And you know, sometimes it's like when you're gazing upon him, it's like the perfect moment in a sunset, or the perfect moment in a sunrise, or the moment that you first saw your baby born, or there's something just so special about the presence of God. And sometimes we come, and if you're waiting for the main attraction, he is the main attraction. This is him. When he's around, you don't need anything else. And God, it's just like sometimes when we're in this place, it's like we love being with him, but he loves being with us just as much. And we say, we love you, God. And he says, I love you more. We say, no, 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 God, we love you so much. And he goes, no, 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 I love you so much. And there's this divine exchange, heart to heart. The word worship is to kiss. And right now, it's like we're kissing heaven. We're kissing the place of the Spirit. And there is nothing more beautiful. There is nothing more beautiful than being with our King. Nothing. So sometimes we're just navigating and just coming down and then going back up and then coming down and then going back up again. And it's just the ebbs and the flows of the Spirit. We've been born of Spirit. And there's transformation happening right now. For some people, there's healing happening right now. For some people, there's restoration happening right now. For some people, there's an injection of faith. For some people, there's hope, fresh hope being released. Whatever it is that God is doing for you right now, this is your moment. This is the moment. And there's no better moment than right now. This is the moment. This is the moment we're in right now. Sometimes we wait for something more. Oh, when this happens, but this is it, right here. I feel like God's saying, what do you want? What can I do for you? There's nothing that I won't do for you. It says, whatever you ask in my name will be done. And so, Father, we thank you for your presence in this place. We bless you. We love you. We honor you. In Jesus' name. Do you know, I had two visions when we were in worship just now. And the first vision, when we were coming into a place of landing, I saw us all on an aircraft. And if you've ever flown on a plane in a beautiful day and you're coming into land, and it's just so peaceful, there's such a tranquility, and you look out the window and it's like it's a moment in time, it's like you're seeing from a heavenly perspective. And I just love when we were singing tonight, we're saying, I see heaven in your eyes. And I felt like what God was doing in that place is he was giving us a heavenly perspective. He was giving us his perspective. And I felt like the Lord say, do you see what I see? Do you see what I see? And you know, I just felt like he was just giving people just such a fresh view of life, a fresh view, a fresh vision of themselves, of their circumstances, of what everything that is going on in their world. And the second image I had was I saw a whole company of eagles, a whole company. It was like, and I know they only fly in ones and twos, but I saw a whole company of eagles, and they were at a cliff face, and they dove down off the cliff face, and they caught a wind as they caught an updraft of the wind as they turned left, and they all went in unison and hit round a sharp left as they turned. And in the spirit, left is the side for the spirit. And as they all came around, they all caught this updraft of the wind, and I saw one word superimposed over the eagles as they were soaring, and it was the word delight. It was the word delight, and it was like that every one of us were taking delight in experiencing the updraft of the spirit. And it says, delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. And I felt like as we were delighting ourselves in his presence, as we were delighting ourselves in experiencing his love and the ebbs and flows of the spirit, I felt like he was answering our prayers, that there was something of him continually just breaking things open in our life that we don't even know about. And it's funny, I was sitting and I said, oh God, that's so amazing. And he said that there are people in here tonight, they don't even know it, but there's some people in here tonight that have lost things naturally. And as a result, what I'm doing right now is I'm actually restoring things in the natural. And I felt like there was people here that might be in a strange relationship with a son, with a daughter, with a brother, with a sister. I felt the Lord was restoring that, even in this place. He says it was a time for the restoration of lost things. It might have been finance for some people. I felt that somebody lost a house, actually lost the whole house, maybe in a divorce or something like that. But I felt, or maybe, I don't know what it was for, but I felt like the Lord say that I'm restoring lost things. And it was in that place of beautiful delight, just enjoying his presence, that he was restoring. It was no effort, it was effortless restoration. So Father, we thank you for effortless restoration tonight, in Jesus' name. We thank you, God, for that you are a restorer of all things. But Father, we thank you, God, on our part, it's effortless, just from that place of delight. And so, Father, we just thank you, God, for everything that you've done and are going to continue to do this evening and today. And Father, we bless you and we honor you in this place, in the name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. Bless you, guys. We can just bless God. But let's just thank the worship team as well. That is just such an awesome...
Yay, God. He's so good, eh?
How beautiful is his presence? There's nothing more special. There's nothing more poor. Oh, Jesus. Welcome to Jubilee this evening. Oh, Jesus. So good to have you with us. Somebody recently lost a wallet. We haven't found one, but did someone recently lose a brown leather wallet? Who was that? Felt very specifically. It folds in half. Is that you, sir? Have you just lost it recently? Did you find it again? Not yet. Can I just pray? Is it brown leather folds in half? Yeah. Let's just pray for you right now. In Jesus' name, I just thank you that the wallet would be found with all the money. In Jesus' name, with everything that was in it, it will be restored. It's a supernatural sign. Father, we thank you for that. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen. So good. Yeah, I saw that very, very clearly during worship. So good. Finn and Izzy, as you might have noticed, aren't with us this evening, but they're here in spirit, so if you do see them, yeah, they are really around, bilocating possibly. Our administrator is on the floor drunk, which is awesome. For those of you that are new to Jubilee, no, we don't do too much alcohol or drugs here, but I said too much. Do you know, a while ago, we had someone come to us as a team, and when they first joined Jubilee, they actually thought that people were giving out ecstasy in the service. Half the staff are ex-drug dealers, but it was so cool. We just love to enjoy and celebrate. Now, as I said, Finn and Izzy are just. Just on the back of doing a conference called the Encounter Conference, or an Encounter Conference in Melbourne, if I could speak. And Geordie was with them, so I'm going to ask him to come up and share a testimony from Melbourne. So,
how's it going? So I just got back from Melbourne yesterday. It was a really, really wild conference. We look forward to it every year. The McGraths are dear, dear friends of ours. They have a beautiful family, also a big family with very similar ages of kids, so it's really great for all the little ones. They all play together, and it's fantastic as well. But the conference was just wild. It was like really, it was really, really raucous. Like some of the meetings went on for 4 or 5 hours. Apparently, the Sunday morning service today went on till 4 p.m. or something like that, 3 or 4 p.m. and it started at 9:30 a.m. So that was, Dad was like, it was just wild. So that's exciting. We probably my highlight. Sorry for those of you who are here this morning. I'm going to be repeating myself, but we had one lady come up and testify during the conference, and she said in the worship, I had this vision, and basically 2 years ago her father had died, and ever since that day she basically just tried to take her life. So she had marks all up her arms. It was really intense, and basically she had this vision of her father, and he said to her, "There isn't a place for you here yet. It's not your time." And she was just like broke down, and God gave her a purpose and a vision, and she knows what she wants, and she has a desire to live now, and it was just crazy. I mean, everyone was tears in their eyes. It was really, really powerful, and that's what it's all about. You know, it's all about people coming to encounter Jesus, and it was really radical. So thanks for your prayers. It was crazy.
That's awesome. So much fun. Finn said they just broke out like crazy. So much fun. Woo! Okay, so this week, just a couple of actually, let's do the offering. I won't do an offering message if there's a team. Awesome. Let's do that. But while we're doing that, I'm just going to tell you a couple of the things that are going to be coming up. Thanks, team. The team are awesome. Yeah, team. Yeah, team. Gosh, there's so much hunger in here tonight. Okay, so this week, Everyone say, no create school. So don't come. If you come, there'll be no one here. Harp and Bowl will still be running as usual Wednesday at 7:30, so come to that. It's super fun. So that's Wednesday. Friday, 7 p.m. nightlife. Geordie and the guys are going to be doing an acoustic sessions. So if you are between the 25-ish and below, please do come along to that. It's going to be wild, super fun. Just lots and lots and lots of that for an extended period, hopefully, which will be awesome. Okay, now Easter Monday parade is on Monday the 21st of April. Wear your camo gear with bright bandanas and meet in Hyde Park at 10 a.m. I actually thought it said bright bananas, but don't bring any bananas. But bring bandanas. So bring some camo gear, bright bandanas, Hyde Park at 10 a.m. for the Easter parade. It's going to be really, really fun. I was just chatting to Jackie about the dates. I said, it's Easter on this coming Friday. Gosh, it's just got a year since last Easter. So quick. Amazing. Okay. So that's Monday. How many people are going to go to that? I just really want to give that a pump. Okay, cool. So we've got a couple of you. If you like to dance and you like to celebrate, come along to that. It will be so much fun. It was just about dancing in the street and celebrating Jesus, celebrating Easter. It's very, very exciting. Okay, so next, the Passion and Fire Conference with Brian Simmons, which is on the 24th to the 26th of April, so in just 2 weeks' time. Now, we have a request. If you were here this morning, you've already heard this, but there are some guys from Adelaide, friends of ours, church, have booked a big group of people to come up, and unfortunately, they were met with a scam online and lost all of their finance for the accommodation. So they booked a whole house for lots of people from the church to come in. They were all ready for action, but it turned out that the website that they used was a false scamming website, and all of their funds were taken from all of them, which is pretty distressing. It was over $2,500. And so Marty Stockdale and the guy, they're very long-standing friends of Jubilee, Geordie and Fin and Iz. And so I spoke to Finny yesterday, and he said, both morning and evening service, can you ask them, can there be a request made to the congregation? This is the request. If you are going away for that weekend, not that you would want to with Brian Simmons coming, but if you are, it's the long weekend, if you are going away and you would be happy for people to stay in your house, or if you suddenly have a brainwave from the Holy Spirit with regards to accommodation, then we'd love to hear from you. So come and talk to, not Belinda, Michelle, or, I'm so used to seeing Belinda there, Michelle or Jackie. So don't worry, I'll see you when I get home. It's not long, it's just a couple of hours, it'll be fine. And register online. You get a reduced rate if you register online for that conference, if you haven't registered yet. So brainwaves about accommodation, if you come up with something, if there's something that you feel like God is asking you to do in that area. But also, if you haven't registered, register online, and you will get a reduced rate. Isn't that good? Now I just want to make some time to just a couple of testimonies, and then we're going to be hearing from from an awesome man of God this evening. So just a couple.
Hi. I've been doing some work with Tony. If anyone doesn't know Tony, he's a legend. There he is, the muscle man. But, whoa, settle down. It's my test. I know, it's ours. The thing God's been speaking to me a lot about lately is the whole, when he multiplies food, he's like, kind of, where are we going to send him, God? It's like, and he's like, you do it. It's like, it's not ministry, it's relationship kind of thing. And it's funny, it's like, I've been really going after the people that just every day, the people that you don't even notice. And this truck driver came in to pick up a pickup, and there's this darker guy, and I was like, hey, what's your name? And he's like, oh, I'm VJ. I'm like, where are you from? Blah, blah, blah. I was really asking into his world and just generally being interested in him. And I had a feeling, but you know what, all those prophetic people are like, there's like, yeah, I had a prophetic thing, but you told me. I was going to say that. God told me you had a problem. Anyway, I was feeling something to do with his legs was wrong or something. And then afterwards he was like, oh, something's up with my leg. I'm like, I knew it. But then afterwards, because we do a lot of bath salts and stuff, and he was like, here, take some salts. It's got a lot of healing agents and like all that kind of stuff. And he's like, and Simon's going to pray for you. That's what Tony said. And I was like, I was going to say I was going to pray for him. I didn't hear that. But anyway, it's been really prophetic. He's a good boss. Then I was like, hey, man, do you believe in God? Oh, Tony said, are you a man of God? And he goes, yeah, yeah. And I go, which God? And he goes, I can't remember the guy. The other one, the elephant one with all the arms and legs and all that kind of jive. That guy. But I was like, that's awesome. Come on. And I was like, we believe in Jesus, and Jesus talks back to us and that kind of thing, and Jesus heals and stuff. So like, can we pray for your feet and legs to see what happens? He's like, oh, yeah. Oh, and my left foot, it's been pins and needles for 2 years. I've gone to all types of doctors, and they'd give me all types of drugs and all kinds of things, and it just doesn't go. And then I was like, oh, let's just go for it. And then we got down and prayed for him. It went a little bit, and I'm like, oh, that's awesome, high five. He left me hanging the first time. And then I prayed again. I was like, let's pray again. And then he was like, oh, it's a little bit better. Wow. It's going in your hand. It goes in your hand. Your energy go in your hand. I'm like, no, it's not going in my hand. And I was like, how is it? And he's like, he's jumping up and down. He's like, oh my goodness, it's nearly good. And I'm like, high five. And he gave me a high five that time. Amen. And then and they're like, oh, so it's not 100%. So I got down again. And then the man of faith, I was like, let's get Tony to pray. He's got more power than I do. No. I said, let's get Tony to pray. But Tony started praying. And then bam, it totally left. And he was like, what you do? What you do? 2 years, all these drugs, all these doctors and stuff. What you do? And then it was hilarious. And he gets up and he's just smart. I'm like, Jesus did that just because he loves you, for Vijay. He loves Vijay, not because of what you do, what you didn't do, or if you know him or you don't know him. He just loves you so much. And that's why he just wanted to show you how much he loves you. But anyway, that was epic.
That's an awesome testimony, hey? Incredible. God is so, so good. Well, I'm so excited to welcome Peter Theodore to come and bring the word. So let's give Peter a Jubilee welcome as he comes to preach.
That's fabulous. You guys are too kind. I've been upgraded from announcements. Woo! It feels good. There is a God. Did you hear that? It feels good. So I'm going to be tempted to do this. Create? No, I'm not. How good was tonight? It was great, wasn't it? So you're going to hear me. And you're going to hear me. And you're going to hear a good message. But I have to do this. Geordie, where is he? Whew. This man, let me prophesy. Prophesy, brother! No. No. But you know what, Geordie? I just want to decree over you. Geordie has unlocked the ancient doors. And Geordie, you haven't diluted the message of Jesus Christ. You haven't diluted the kingdom of God, and you've been unadulterated with my presence. You have been unadulterated with my presence. And I sense that you're going into truth. Truth of the gospel. Truth of the cross. Truth of the blood. Truth of the love of God. And you're a young man. And you're a young man. And you haven't stepped away with my truth. And I feel the Lord says this to you. That his presence is going to rest on you. And your father has contended for the glory of the Lord, and so has your mother. And your mother and father have been pioneers in bringing the presence of the Lord into the house. And you are going to see the presence of the Lord through your lifetime. And what I sense, the Lord's going to open the doorways to heaven for you, and he's going to give you access to the spiritual realm to see the four living creatures, and you're going to make it so close to the four living creatures, you are going to feel the supreme presence of the Lord. And what I really feel, you're going to be a carrier of the love of God. And you know how when people take things and it's not mixed, but it's pure like alcohol or drugs, you are going to bring pure love back that hasn't been corrupted or hasn't been tainted. And I just decree that on you, Geordie. And as you release worship, you're going to come back down to earth with the presence of God. And the Lord says, it's only by my spirit that people worship. It is not by you. Did you hear that? It is only by my spirit. And I am allowing you to open people's hearts to be vulnerable to me, buddy. And you're going to see people open themselves up to the living God. And you're going to see people like tonight be abandoned, surrendered. And you're going to love it. And the Lord says, you're going to carry the weight of my love when I'm releasing myself. Whoa. And you're going to carry my love. And you're going to be so intoxicated and carried away, you're not even going to know yourself that you've possessed the living God. And I just release that. You're going to take people to encounters. You're going to take people through places of encounters with the living God, and they're going to encounter his love. And it's not going to be head knowledge. You can't put presents in a box. And I just release you. Isn't that great? Whoa! I'm not going to prophesy. That was a good word. Yeah, I'll do what I mean. Do you know what? But wasn't tonight beautiful? It was so, I was like, I'm going to get to the message, but it was so abandoning. I was so abandoned. I was so in love. I was so surrendered. It was so weighty. Could you feel the weight of that? We want more. We want more. And you know what I'm going to speak tonight? Get ready. My favorite topic. Crowns, swords, and scrolls. We are going to unlock heaven, and we're going to get our crowns back. Some of you are going to go to the treasury room, and you're going to put on crowns. And some of you, we're going to go in to get our swords. We're going to get our weaponry. We're going to get everything we want from the kingdom, and we're going to go into the inventory. Are you ready? And we're going to go for scrolls. And you're going to get your scrolls. You're going to get your life scroll. And you're going to be imparted, but I'm going to show you what scrolls are. You know what I love about John? John says, if I could write everything what Jesus did, there wouldn't be enough books in the world. And I think there's a part in Psalm that says, if we could capture all of God's thoughts, there wouldn't be enough sand to capture them. If you could see what God has written about you, if we could capture everything that Jesus has about you, there wouldn't be enough books. Your scroll is long. Oh, I haven't even started. And we're gonna tap into your scroll, and we're gonna release it from heaven. Are you ready? Okay. I'm gonna take you on a journey. I'm gonna take you a bit of my journey, and I'm gonna show you. We're gonna walk through some scrolls. We're gonna walk through crowns. Remember that. Swords. And what was the third thing? Scrolls. I'm gonna take you through seasons in your life. We're going to go through some really hard seasons, if you're with me. It's disappointments and discouragements, injustice, malpractice, hatred, rejection. We're going to walk through those seasons, but we're going to get our swords back, and we're going to get our crowns back, and we're going to get our scrolls back, and then we're going to face Destiny Thief. And we're going to say to Destiny Thief, get out, get lost. And we're going to kick Destiny Thief out, and then we're going to go to the place of the most holy place when God is silent. When God is silent, what is happening in the silence? Are we ready? Okay, I have no idea where we're going to go next. I need my water. Are we ready? Here we go. Flick, 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 flick. You know God's got a destiny for you. God's got a great agenda and a great plan. And I want us just to untap a bit of that plan tonight. And what I want to do, we're going to go on this journey. And what I would like to do to get the most out of this journey, I'm going to help you activate your crown. I'm going to help you activate your scroll. I'm going to help you activate. We're going to go into rooms and we're going to pull them out. but we're also going to go on earth and we're going to grab them and I'm going to help you recognize with them. So to get the most out of this journey, you have to follow me. Do you get me? So we're going to do some things and I want you to be vulnerable with your dreams. So I want you to think about, what are you passionate about? What are you passionate about? Let's not be afraid. This is a transformational center. What are you passionate about? What makes you come alive? You see, when the musos play, they're alive. We're touching God, but they're in another realm of creativity. And they love it. Look at my Fender. Look at this. Look at my pedals. Look at, you know. I have no idea that they're alive. What makes you come alive? What do you desire? What are your gifts? What are your talents? And this is it. Are you ready? I can't even find mine. Okay, my mission statement. So I'm going to be vulnerable. My mission statements are two things. There's 10 of them. Equip and empower people to fulfill their God-given destiny. I'm doing that tonight. That's my first mission, okay? My second mission is in the corporate world to be a trusted advisor like Joseph or Daniel as a corporate advisor to senior management. They're my missions, okay? I'm going to walk you through some of those missions, and those missions have cost me heaps, okay? They don't come easy. I wish they did. So I'm going to go through some stuff with you, and I want you to unlock what your mission and what your purpose is. Are you ready? And I want you to be vulnerable. Ministry, I'm going to read some stuff out. And as I read it out, tell me if it resonates. We're going to go through family. We're going to go through career. We're going to go through business. We're going to go through education. And we're going to go through creative personal achievements. And we're going to unlock these things, okay? And we're going to push some boundaries. Are we ready? In ministry, we have callings. And as I'm prophesying, we're going to have mantles being released over these things over you. And in these callings, we're going to have preachers. Woo! I didn't mean that one. We're going to have pastors and shepherds. And there's a lot in this place. We're going to have teachers, people who love to teach and expound the truth. We're going to have people who move in help, in admin, discipling, healing, social justice, social justice, evangelism, prophetic, and intercession. Now just allow yourself, start to dream again. Another great thing with ministry is the relationship with God, the Son, and the Spirit. That goes without saying. There's going to be mantles, metrons, giftings. And really what's powerful is missionary and church planting. These are the things this church is made for. Start believing those things. Are we done? So that's... Keep going. Family. I'm going to push the boundary on this one. Marriages. Marriages to be restored and enriched. And I'm going to go further. To find a husband. And I'm free, by the way. And to find... I'm on the shelf. And we're going to... I'm out there, seriously. And... Come on, Mike. Come on, baby. Let me keep going. If you want to find girls, not for me. Ladies, if you want a husband, we're going to release dreams and desires tonight. Dreams and desires. Don't push, don't hold back. Husbands and wives, okay? Let's push those boundaries. Children. Children saved. There's lots of children out there that aren't saved. Your daughters, your sons. We want our children healed and we want them successful. Boundary pusher, pregnancy. I'm going for the barrenness. Going for the barrenness, okay? I'm going to push on that. I'm going for the barrenness, okay? We're going to go for having children where we can't have children. Okay, let's go hard on that. You know why? These are dreams and desires, and destiny thief wants to shut up and wants to keep us locked down. They're hard zones, and it's like the marriage. It makes you feel like it's helpless and it's hopeless, but it's not. Okay, ready? Healthy, whole, and fit. Yeah, okay. Next, buy a home. Buy a home, pay it off, and move to a new location. That's a big one. Okay, business. This is big. Business plans are going to get released tonight. So I just welcome anyone like Daryl, anyone who just wants to just minister in that area. Laura, just start to just feel free releasing business plans to people. Okay? It's not hard. And I'm going to tell you something in a minute. Business plan. Start your own business. Expand your business and reduce your business debt. For those of us who are stuck in a job, get a promotion. Meet your targets if you're in sales and develop into leadership. Or find a new job. Or a new role. Last two, quickly, education and academics. Okay, who's in uni? Keep going to uni. Who stopped? Who needs to go back? And who needs to excel? Okay, and the last one is the best one. This church is full of creativity. It's oozing. It's a creative center. And the world says you can't compete against us. Yeah, we got the sauce, bro. We got the sauce. We got Mr. Creative. Do you know what I love about you? If you want to be creative, you've got to buy paints. You've got to buy canvas if you're going to paint. He doesn't have anything. He is create. And we got him. Personal achievements. Okay. There's an angel scribe here tonight, and he's going to help someone write a book. He's going to help us write songs and release songs. Not just the bandies here. They've done it. Tick. They just need bigger metrons. Regional, national, international. Woo! Push the boundary. That's what we're going for. We're going to push boundaries. Okay. Multimedia. Move into multimedia. Release CDs. And I love this one. Design musical instruments. Isn't that good? That's a good one. And sound. I love this one. Travel the world. And innovate. Can't remember the last one. Innovate. Okay. How was that? I want you to pick two. Okay. Did you get that? I hope you got two. I got my two. This is the journey, because it's no point in me telling, this is it. Go for it. We're going to break the boundaries. If you want a wife, woohoo, take it. Okay. Going to release that dream. If you want to go for a new home, if you want a different purpose in church planting, if you want to start being creative and writing a book, this is it. This is the part you become vulnerable, and it's safe because you're in the kingdom. Okay, the Nathaniel experience. If you want to go to 1 John 45:50, I love this verse. This is my favorite. This is going to be not the crux, because we're going to get to crowns, swords, and scrolls in a minute. Let me read this to you. Philip found Nathaniel and told him. Do we have it up yet? If you don't, that's fine. No, don't worry about it. Philip found Nathaniel and told him, "We have found the one Moses wrote about in the law, and about whom the prophets also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of David." We found him too. "Nazareth, can anything good come from here?" Nathanael asked. "Come and see," said Philip. And when Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, he said, "Here truly is an Israelite whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked, "How do you know me?" Got that the wrong way around. And Jesus answered, "I saw you while you were under the fig tree, before Philip called you." And Nathanael declared, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." And Jesus said, "You believe because I told you I saw you under the fig tree? You will see greater things than that." He then added, "Verily, truly, I tell you, you will see," punchline for tonight, "heaven open, and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." Did you hear that? That's our punchline. Tonight we're going to have two things. We're going to have the fig tree here. You can line up on the fig tree, and we're going to have the angels on this side, ascending and descending. This side. Okay? Now, we're going to talk about how this is going to work. I'm not going to get you to activate, so don't worry. But I'm going to tell you, you've got a choice. And let's start. When I was going to Israel, I sat next to this Jewish man. And he, you know, had all his curls and all that, really Jewish Orthodox. And I used to read a Jewish Messianic Bible at the time, you know, Yehuda, and, you know, could hachokadeh, the Holy Spirit. And he goes, "You know so much about our culture." I thought, well, I know Jesus, that's why. And then his name, I think, was, I don't know if it was Jacob or something like that. And I go to him, tell me about the story of Jacob. You know the story where Jacob was at Bethel, and he was at the place at Bethel, and he lied on the rock, and there was angels. What were they doing? They were ascending and descending. And Jacob said, I did not know God was in this place. It's exactly the same verse. You know what I love? He goes to me, did you notice it said that angels of God were ascending and descending? They didn't come down from heaven. They were going up and then coming down. Our mentality is they're up there. Brother, they're here. They are here. That was a Jewish man. I go, ooh, that's a good word. Shalom. And he had 12 kids. 12. God, I had two. Anyway, the Nathaniel experience. I'm off the rails. Fig tree. Do you know the fig tree was first mentioned in Genesis 3 when Adam and Eve left the garden and they sewed fig leaves on themselves to cover their shameful identity. They were naked and they were exposed. And the fig tree represents to me, because it means a lot of good things too, the old nature. And Nathaniel, where was he? Under a fig tree, the victim. And we're going to get rid of the victim tonight. And I'm going to walk you through the shameful nature and we can sit under the victim. And I'm going to tell you how many times I've sat under that fig tree. Let me tell you, I grew up with fig trees. I know what a fig tree looks like and it's ugly. And my dad always used to say, if it doesn't bear fruit, we cut it. Oh, man. I cop that one all the time. And let me tell you, I saw fig trees go every year. And I thought, man, calm down. But you know what I love about Jesus? And we heard it tonight, and Daryl mentioned it. And so did Jordy. I'm losing my names. The love of Jesus, the eyes, you see it in his eyes. 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 You see it. And I love, picture yourself as Nathaniel. He goes up to Nathaniel and he encourages him. Oh, let me tell you, the countenance of his eyes. You are going to start to see the countenance of his eyes. You're going to see those eyes. Their eyes, they look at you. They love you intently. And you don't want it to be broken. Don't leave me. Don't break your look, Jesus. And then he smiles, and you're studying his whole countenance. And that countenance is intently about you. Every part of his face is absorbed about you. And then he speaks, he opens his mouth. Oh, he just, I love you. Look at this person, there's nothing bad in them. He has total integrity. And Nathaniel's sold. He's sold. And you'll be sold. That's a good word. And the Lord's going to keep showing us his face. Don't break his eyes. Don't break contact from his eyes. And he's going to feed you with those eyes. He's going to feed you. And those countenance, that look, that expression, you're going to drink it. You're going to, oh, Daddy, more. Oh, I got more. And you know what I love? He saw Nathaniel before he saw him. And he sees you before you see him. He saw him. Nobody knows me. Nobody recognizes me. Nobody. That's me. Nobody. Not even me. I saw you. And then I love this. Can anything good come out of me? Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Can anything good come out of me? That's fig tree mentality. So I want to take you to fig tree. It's over here. We're gonna probably chop the fig tree down tonight. Woo! And here we've got angels. Remember, they're not coming down. You've got no faith for that. We might do an ascension exercise later. I'll do that later. But that's a good one. But angels are here to walk with you, to greet you. Do you understand? And they go up and they go down. They don't come down. They're not going to come and get me. I can't see. I haven't got spiritual vision. I haven't got sight. They're here, brother. That's me. It's no one here. It's me. And they are no, what is it? Prejudice, okay? No favor. I mean, they do have favor. So, Yeah, no respecter of person. Don't you love it? Okay, are you ready? Shameful passive identity statements. They're going tonight. These statements cause you so much harm. And these statements stop you from receiving the eyes of Jesus. These statements, they're platforms for the enemy. Let me land on one of those. I'm not good enough or worthy. I'm not confident. I don't have what it takes. I'm afraid. I'm so anxious. Now, I'm not making fun of anyone. These are shameful identity. I'm not smart. I'm not attractive. I'm going to be rejected. I don't fit in or belong. I'm going to be overlooked and no one cares. I'm going to fail and I'm going to make mistakes. I'm going to be exposed. I'm going to be alone. Are you ready? Tape recorder on. We're going to erase all that rubbish. That's rubbish. 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 It's not the language of heaven. It is not the language of the Father or the Son or the Spirit. It's from the fig tree. I don't go back to a fig tree, Dad. We cut it. I'm going to bring him. We cut it. Cut it. We cut it. Okay. Remember your dreams, the two of them. Okay. What are they? Number one. Let's say I want to find a partner. Let's say I'm going to be vulnerable. I'm not good enough. I recognize it. Step number one. No formula here, okay? I renounce it. I renounce that lie. Then step into the transformation center. Holy Spirit, give me a meaning of transformation. You're an awesome dude. Ooh. Transformation messages. Now, let me tell you what we need. Don't just replace it with a positive statement. Go into the Spirit of God. Go into the countenance of the living God and let Him birth it over you. Let Him blow it and whisper those transformational messages. You are competent. You are amazing. You don't know what those words mean, but you know what? They're going to chop down that fig tree. Okay, let's keep going. How are we going? Gotta hurry up. Seasons. Ugh. Don't you love seasons? Seasons, they come and they go. And today was crappy weather. And all of us have to pass through seasons. I hate seasons sometimes. And Daryl always preaches this, and so does Izzy. You grow, it's a process, it's family, and keep doing it. We need it. We just can't. Here's your scroll. You won't last. But seasons are important because you know why? They shape you. The season is needed to shape you. So when seasons come, they're going to shape you. And you get to choose the fig tree in a season. And I see this all the time. Or you get to choose this one. You're going to go up. Hey, they're not going to go up. You're going to go up. I'm going to do that next. And these are the seasons. Are you ready? Seasons of disappointment and discouragement. Nothing good happens, even when I pray. Dryness. God, where are you? Where are you? This is what I say. If I was you, I wouldn't treat anyone like that. I would speak. I would give the full picture. I wouldn't. I'm crying out. Don't you get it? It's human contact. You know, it's like talking. Talk back to me. Touch me. You're invisible. I don't get it. And a lightning bolt. Well, that's how I feel. Temptation. I looked up the top temptations, and I'm not going to do this in this season. I bet you it's sex, and I bet you it's porn for men. Well, it's not. I thought, well, scratched my head. So, ladies, let them go. But get off it, men. Procrastination. Whew. My God, anxiety and fear. And I think, are they sins? Procrastination. Food. Come on. But I'm not going to go into temptation. But you have seasons when you can't do the right thing. I just want to do the right thing. Romans chapter 7. The thing that I want to do, I can't do it. Everything I try to do, I can't do it. Is that a good word? Friend of mine, I shouldn't say, but I know someone who's struggling with something, everyone does. And let's say, and the human nature is so complicated. Let me tell you, if you are in a really bad situation and your emotions are heightened, your senses are then heightened, and your sensuality is through the roof, you're going to be tempted to be sexual. You will be tempted to do bad things. But you need to understand your sensuality is heightened. That's a good word. Do you sin? No. But understand it, because people go, I'm so close to God, but my senses, your senses are out of control. So what do? Give me those eyes. Give me those eyes. Transform it, because it's really needing transformational love. Crowns, we're here. Woo! That took a long time, but I was just trying to build you there. Okay, let's recap. Victory with my dad. We drop it down. It's going down. And then we go to the Jewish man. I can't even do an accent. What are they, you know? Blah, 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 blah. Shalom. The angels. Crowns. I love them. Revelations 3:11. I'm coming soon. And all the women go, yes, come. Hold on to what you have so that no one will take your crown. Your crown. This is your crown. We're going to get it. And those who haven't got it, you're going to put it on. And you're going to hold it up. And we're going to declare it to the spirit realm in the heavens and on the earth and under the earth that this is my authority. And this is my place to rule, like Adam was given authority to rule and reign. You got it? This is your place to rule. Without this, you can't rule. There are two Greek words. My parents never taught me Greek, and here they go. The first Greek word, I was going to do the Hebrew, but oh, there was five of them. Zachaher, Dechala. I thought, forget that. Zachaber. I got that. You gotta have fun. Now you're gonna see. Now you're gonna see comedian Pete. And will I have fun? It's gonna get wilder. Okay, you ready? Okay. Okay. The them. D-I-A-D-E-M. I can't say it because I don't know what it means. They are them. It's like a diamond, it looks like. Symbolic of power to rule. Okay? Number two, my brother's name, Stephanos. Made of leaves of gold, used for festive occasions to express public recognition. Now here we go. This is when crowns are used. Crowns are used for decoration. So girls, when you get your crown tonight, knock yourself out. I'm not going there. Mine's going to be rough. Dipped in blood and battered. Yeah. But whoever wants diamantes and velvet and all that stuff, we're going to colour them. Crowns are going to be used for consecration. And some of you tonight, the Lord is going to say, I've marked you Yahweh. That's what the high priest would have, a little golden crown, and it would say Yahweh, marked for service, marked by the holy God, Yahweh. Get ready for that one. Next one is coronation. You're going to be crowned tonight in a coronation service. And we're going to go to the throne room for that. And we're going to go into the treasury in a minute. Okay? When we go there, some of you are going to be exalted. And some of you are going to be remunerated. I'm going to read a few things and then we're going to start. Crowns, two things. Let's read some scripture to back all this up. 2 Timothy 4:8. There's a crown of righteousness. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness. Don't let anyone take away your righteousness. You are right in Jesus. That's a crown. Walk and rule in that. 1 Peter 5:4. When the great shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory. That will never fade away. Glory. This church is glory church. Now this one is, there's an anointing on this one, and it's not a good one. James 1:12. Blessed is the person who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord promised to those who love him. And I felt the Lord say this to me, that I am giving the crown of life tonight, that you have gone through trials and tests, and you have stood through injustice, and this crown is a crown of recognition and remuneration for what has been stolen from you. And you will wear this crown, and this crown will be a sign to the enemy that this person has been restored and given back to the Lord, and you will be given back to your full authority and honor. And I really feel for those who've been mistreated and stood, this crown is for you. Don't take this crown lightly. There's a lot of weight on that word for that person, whoever that is. Recognized, rewarded. Sure. Revelations 2:10, be faithful even to the point of death, and I will give you life as a victor's crown. So, wrap up. Activate time. Two crowns, right to rule and reign. We're going to get those. And crowns, are you ready for it? Of reward and recognition. They're the crowns that come from heaven. They're scriptural, all that stuff. You saw them. So you're going to wear crowns tonight for your, remember your dreams, and rule and reign. And for all the hard effort you've done, God says, here's a reward and recognition because I recognize good behavior. It's not waiting because Jesus just died on the cross. What did he do? He went up to Nathanael and he says, what a great guy. That's integrity there. That's integrity there. And God sees you and says, that is integrity. That is honor. And I reward and I give back to you. That's the God we serve. Show me those eyes. Okay, crowns are going to be picked up. And where they've been dropped, this is where I become vulnerable. Okay, seasons of malpractice and injustice. I haven't been through much injustice or malpractice, and I'm sure a lot of people have. Marriage has ended. That was hard. Losing finances, losing family, partner, children, going through work situations, being falsely accused. I've had my fair share. And you guys have walked through a lot of seasons of injustice. But we serve a God who's justice. And what I want to do, I'm going to go through an activation. You don't have to do this with me. But while I'm walking through my activation, this is how I draw a crown out, okay? This is stuff that I've learned on the way from hearing people, not hearing. I like that, don't like that. You don't have to like this. This is a good word. I was in a great season. I loved life. I was here with the angels. Angels go up, angels go down. And I was there and I go, I love it. I've got all the power and all the authority. And I'm at work. Remember my mission? To be a trusted advisor to senior management. And I go, I've got all the authority. I'm a great leader. I'm really spiritual. It's all going for me. And I have this one individual. And I say to myself, this is about 2010-ish. And this individual's giving me a hard time. So I decide I'm going to exercise my power and authority and I'm going to have the person exited. They'll know who's boss. And I thought, this is cool. I'm getting my, you know what, back? My punch. I was going to say something else, but I'm not. No. And I sat there. So I sat the person down and I go, here you go. And I'm not being, I was quite true to my word with it. Hello, season shift. Where did that come from? Well, this person lodges a formal grievance on me, goes for months, we get external parties in. I thought, whoa, where did that come from? I got the Spirit of God on me. I was with Nathanael under that tree. I sat under that tree. Oh man, I've lost my joy, I've lost my motivation, I can't even pray for people, this is killing me. And I was in a season of injustice, of being falsely accused. And I knew I was. But the enemy, he had me thinking, it must be me. There's some truth in that. I must have done something to deserve it. I could have done that. I'm a perfectionist like Geordie. I got to get the tuning right. And, you know, I kept condemning myself. What did I do? And you know what? Let's activate these crowns. Revelation time. Number one, you're in a battle. I don't care what you think. And you're not in a battle against another human being. Get that off your radar. You got to love these people. Get people off your radar in terms of they're the enemy. They are not your enemy. They are pawns. And they don't even know it at times. And they need to be loved. And that transformational love will get through to them. But the enemy uses people, but the enemy also uses his own agents in the unseen realm. And I started to see for the first time, which I hadn't seen before, that I wasn't wrestling against this individual. I was wrestling against unseen forces. Hello, I know all the scriptures. You don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but about powers and principalities and heavenly places. I can quote it. I can quote an NIV and King James. But I couldn't see it. So I sat under the fig tree. What were my shameful messages? I'm weak. I'm a nobody. And then I discovered the crown. The crown. Listening to stuff, understanding stuff, and I realized I've given up my crown. The enemy's come through this individual. And the enemy will make you sin. Do you hear what I said? He'll make you sin. Or he'll make you give that person, he'll steal that from you. Or he'll make you give it up. And I gave it up. I gave up my crown. And this is what you do. I went back into the spirit realm. I want to educate you on this stuff, and you know this stuff already. We're going to teach it how to step in. And when you step in, there is no time in this realm. We're going to step in, and we're going to visit events. And when you go visit events, Holy Spirit's going to take you there. And when he takes you there, you're going to see things. And so I step back in the spirit realm. Okay, I'm there, Holy Spirit. I know where I dropped it. I dropped my crown right there. And I had the person right next to me, like a living laboratory, the Holy Spirit. And I said, Father, forgive me because I gave up what you gave me, a divine mission. And I've been crying out to you, Father, to give it back, but I gave it up. So I repent for giving up my crown. And I forgive this individual for causing me to drop it. And I went down and I picked up my crown in the spirit realm. And I said, Holy Spirit, can you coronate me? And I knelt down and the Holy Spirit put that crown back on to rule. Come on. And he put the crown back on my head and he said, my son, I give you the authority to rule and reign. I'm going to give you back places. I give you back your integrity. I give you back your honor. I give you back your leadership. I give you back your mantle. And I felt myself like drinking in. And I just thought, whoa. I just got my authority back to rule. It's like Simba's back. Mufasa. I love it. And I've seen so many people in sessions. God's called you. What are your missions? Is it leadership? What's your purpose? What is it? Is it church planning? What is it? Is it evangelism? What is it? Healing. And healing's an attacking assault. It's an assault on the enemy when you don't see things to make you doubt. What is it if you want to write a book or music and you're assaulted by the enemy in those areas? Anyway, so I just want you to encourage you. You can either do that while I was doing that. We're not going to do any more. We're going to go into swords next. But go back and take that crown. Hold on to that crown. Hold on. And for those of you who don't have a crown, you go with these guys. And you go to the treasury. Go to the treasury. Papa, what do you think of me? What crown are you going to give me? And he'll crown you. You're royalty anyway. You're royalty. Don't. And you know what? This really bugs me. This bugs me the most. Don't be passive. Passive, shameful identity. Wait for something to happen. Go grab it at times. Go get it. It's yours. It's yours. Jesus says, there's many places I've created for you. It's yours. Don't wait for it to drop. Even though tonight we're going to see things drop, it's yours. I welcome you in to go boldly into the throne of grace. Papa, I want my crown, and I want it really big, and I want it purple, and I want lots of diamonds. Can you give me that? And I remember once I had this man, and he gave up his desire for leadership through sexual brokenness. And we went back and we got his crown. You don't know this person, so don't worry. We went back and we got his crown, and he had his crown, and the Lord was just restoring him. I restore back your purity. I restore back your honor. I restore you back as my son. And he's holding his crown, and I'm with him in this session, and I say, now throw it back at Jesus' feet. He takes it off, and he joins the elders around the throne, and we together throw our crowns back off. And we throw them at Jesus, and we just get sucked into another vortex of love. Try that with your crown. That will rock you off. And you know what? He looked amazing with mine. We took selfies. Got lots of like. I like that. Swords. I'm not going to take my time on swords. No journey or adventure is complete without the right tools or equipment. You need the equipment, men. Men love their tools. I've been in the hardware store for the last 6 months. I haven't seen one woman there yet. No, not for a marriage, but anyway. We've got so many talents and skills and spiritual gifts to empower us, but there are times God wants us to grow our giftings, our authority. You've got it. You've got it. How many people do I talk to? How old are you? 40, 50, 60. And what are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? You've got it. You've got it. You've got skills. You've got gifts. You've got anointings. And if you want me to take you into the immaculate conception of Jesus, where Jesus hovers over you and you look at all Jesus' attributes and say, I want your confidence. And Jesus shows you all his confidence. And then he steps in your body. You've got it. You've got everything. If you don't have it, they've got it. Jesus, I want your brain. I want your love. Show me your courage. Show me your meekness. Step into, he'll show it to you, and then let him step into your body. Okay? So, tools, upgrades, equipment. I love this. Moses had a staff. I love that staff. So we're going to see staffs come out tonight. Remember, wherever he put that staff, he threw it down, and it turned into snakes, and the snakes up the sorcerers. I love that story. He touched the Red Sea, did all this stuff. I want that rod. And that is, I think, Moses, Aaron's rod. It's in the tabernacle. We're going to get it back somehow. I don't know. Jesus has a sword coming out of his mouth. Don't you love that sword? And Elisha, he has the mantle of Elijah. What are your weapons? Okay, another season of intimidation and disappointment. I'm back at the office, the mission. Here I am. Give it to me, Lord. Seasons shift again. I'm with this male boss, dominating, intimidating. That is not hard for me. Crushes me. Crushes everyone. He had demons on his lip. They were everywhere. Couldn't help himself. He made everyone feel powerless and helpless. But that's how he got his power. And he made me feel far from my goal. Trust me. I was back here again. No, 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 no. Man, the fig tree's grown again. I'm the only fruit it has. We chop it down. Oh, it's going to be so good, isn't it? Okay, but I knew about crowns by then. He's saying, I've dropped my sword. I'm going to go back and pick up my sword. And I remember I came into Jubilee, and when I'm not a vulnerable person in terms of asking for prayer, but I went for prayer that day, and I stood here. And as I stood here, I went up, no. I stood here. And I went to get my sword. I went back in the realm, you do it. Anytime, I knew where I dropped it. I went down and I picked it up, and I felt the Lord say, drop it. What? I've done this 100 times. Drop it. Drop it. I caused you to drop it, and I brought that season in so you could drop your weapon to get a new weapon. You're going to get new weapons. Human nature, we go back to the old. You go back to the comfort zone. You go back to the things you're good at. Let it go. You're going to grow. New authority, new metron was released on me that day. A new metron. And I went in and I go, oh man, I'm going to get a new sword. And I pick it up and it's like, I felt the Lord say to me, a new metron of authority on you to speak against demonic. You know, when Jesus says, this one comes out with much prayer. Jesus had just had more measure of the Spirit. And from that day, I had more measure of the Holy Spirit in my sword. And I went home and the Lord says to me, that's not it. What else do you need? And he took me through a Roman inventory list of all weaponry. And I went through it and I thought, this is too easy. This is fun. Stop limiting it. And I said, I need protection from demon lips. And you got to understand there's two things. There's Greek and there's Hebrews. And the Greeks are very intellectual. I'm very intellectual. And I learn everything intellectually and then I jump into the encounter. And I went through and I go, I need protection. And I saw this little shield. I go, I don't want a shield of faith. And I see this Roman soldier and he's got a shield front all the way down. Front and back. And I go, whoa! I want that shield, Papa. I don't want a little shield. I want the big shield. And I step back in the realm. I let his armor bearers come. Don't do it yourself. Don't do it yourself. He's got armor bearers. Let them dress you. These are spiritual tools. They're not natural tools. They're spiritual tools. We're dealing with spiritual realms here. And so I put on my outfit. And I had my outfit on. And I went back to Demon Lips. Totally forgot about my shield. Totally forgot. And I'm sitting there, and Demon Lips is just cursing. Gets to me. Thinking, Demon Lips is missing me. What's going on? I go back home and I process it. And I feel the Holy Spirit say to me, you got your shield on and he can't get through. And he's not going to get through. Let me tell you, you don't only have a shield, you got hosts of angels. You've got a whole battalion that are assigned. Assigned to go before you, around you, behind you. Step into that realm. Do you know when Solomon would go in, he'd have a whole, you know, he'd have his little couch, like Jesus takes you in, and behind the whole perimeter of his tent, he'd have battalions of people. And it's like when Jesus takes you in, there's lots of angels all around. You can take Jesus into the office, into the home, into the car. That's pretty crazy. Swords. Go get one. Got a little bit to go and when we're done. Scrolls. Are we all right for time? Are we right? I can wrap up. Scrolls. I love scrolls. Everyone loves scrolls. Give me a scroll. Blueprints of a design that no one else knows. We're going to get there, but let's go realistic first. I love scrolls. Now, read everywhere in the Bible where scrolls exist. So read the scriptures first before we start going into realms. Okay, then we go into realms because the blueprint's up there first, but there's an indication down here of what they're meant for. Scrolls have messages on them, hello, and assignments. They're mentioned in the Old Testament. Now, let me tell you, God has a scroll, a record book in heaven right now for you. Get that into your head. If you don't, I don't know what direction I have. I want guidance. I want clarity. I'm confused. Full record blueprint of your life. And that blueprint is there right now. We're going to go into the library or to the archives. And you're going to get your book out. And if you don't get your book out, get the next page or chapter out for something. Like Kindle, download it. Or go get it. Roland Buck, who's heard of him? Lived in Idaho. He's a pastor. In 1977, he had an angel Gabriel visitation. And God took him to the throne room. And in the throne room, he gave him 120 future events. And then he sealed those 120 events into his brain. And those 120 events actually took place. So we want to go to those places as well. But before we go to the impartation, let's see what Scripture says. When Moses defeated the Amalekites, I don't know if you know that story, and he had his hands and the rod was back. I think the rod was there. I hope the rod was there. I might be wrong. Afterwards, it was decreed that you will write this on a scroll to remember the victory. And you guys have won so many battles. There, you need to record them on your scroll. Well, anyway, they're already recorded. And you need to drag those scrolls out of your spirit and go, wow. Remember that victory. Don't go for a new scroll. We'll get there. But draw out that existing scroll where you conquered. Draw it out of your spirit. And then read it. It's a living scroll. It's not dead. It's alive. When Joshua got to go to the promised land, they surveyed the whole land, sussed it all out, and they put it on a scroll. So some of us have got scrolls of business plans, how we're going to succeed and how we're going to make it. Okay? Then when Saul was made king, they had to write down his rights and his privileges on a scroll. Then on scrolls, they had to decree future plans. Woohoo! We're going to get that, don't worry. And obviously the obvious two, Scripture is recorded on a scroll. That's the Word of God. And the last one, it has prophetic words. So all I'm going to say to you now is you have so many scrolls inside you. You have the Word of God. Draw it out. It's a scroll. Don't wait for this invisible blueprint. It'll come. But first be wise with what you have. You got prophetic words. How many prophetic words have you received? What has God told you? Read them. Wow. Show the enemy. Look at this. Demon lips. Don't you love scrolls? And you know what? Angels are going to deposit scrolls in you too tonight. Remember, we're going to go over here. We can go back there. This is what happened, and that one happened, and that one happened, and then this happened, and that happened, and this happened to my life, and that happened to my life. Oh, my God. Chop the tree. Or we go here. Put a new scroll in, angel. Yeah, there's going to be angel scribes. And I just sense the scribes are going to record what you say. And your words are going to be recorded in books for the living God. But I also feel there's going to be scribes assigned. And we always say these words. Don't take these words lightly. But you're going to get help. And you're going to get scribing angels. And they're going to help you scribe whatever you need. Start to draw on them. Start to open up your spirit to them. And you're going to be lodged in your spirit, lodged in your heart. Even when you go to bed, expect to wake up. Start to draw on that realm. I went through the Roland Buck story because he's that, as prophetic church, we love that. I love that. 150 future events. You'll get them. Okay, 2 points and we're done, then we can land. Oh, this is my favorite time for the destiny thief to be evicted. I've learned so much. Just a glimpse. Back at work again. I'm going to get there. Man, maybe something's wrong with me. And I have all this favor for one full year. One full year of total favor. Got someone who loves me, raises me up. I go, I'm going there. Woohoo, power. Yeah. Overnight shift. Oh, God. Why another season? Another one? The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And there are destiny changes, and there are destiny thieves to take you off course. And this is what I learned in this lesson. I thought, what? Destiny thieves? I don't know about that one. I don't know. I feel uncomfortable. And I saw in my office, and I saw this particular woman come in, and she stole my promotion. And I went, what? I just got to be patient, get on my knees, wait for the Lord to rise me up. It's not a thief. She's not a thief. She's lovely. She's beautiful. Hello. Oh, man. And I could see the destiny thief had got in. I'm going to tell you something here. And this is how it all works. You've got an inheritance. You've got a birthright. And that birthright is in here. And it's linked to heaven. And just as there is angelic scribes, there are demonic scribes. And you know what they're waiting for you to do? Sell your birthright to us. Reshape your words. Frame your world around ours. Give it up. Give it up. Join the fig tree. We cut it down. And the demonic realm, it's a hard word, is waiting for you to shift your words. Because words are the most powerful weapon you have. And when it's the word of the Lord, it's unrefutable. But the enemy wants to shift your words. And I sat there and I go, this always happens to me. I'm never going to get there. I'm not good enough. And for the first time I saw that my words were being scribed. And the destiny thief needed them. Yes, come on, Peter, do it. Do it, I've done it. Good. Now let's fulfill it. And I sat there and I went, no more. Bus in Hindi is enough. Enough. And I sat there and I stepped and I went back in the realm. And this is what I did. Father, forgive me for misusing my words. Forgive me for empowering the enemy to carry weight on the words of my spirit. I'm very prophetic, you guys know that. And I prophesied doom. And I was prophesying gloom. And I was selling my birthright. And then I said, Father, forgive me. Holy Spirit. And this is what I did. I renounce the power of my words. And I speak into the spirit realm and I retract every word that I've ever spoken or released that is unholy. And Holy Spirit, I ask you burn every remnant. I give you permission to burn every trace of that word, because I am going to cancel the assignment of the enemy, because I empowered him. And I went and I canceled the assignment in the name of Jesus. And I took back my words. And then I turned to the destiny thief. He's a real person. Come on, these aren't concepts. It's a real realm. And I turned and I said, in the name of Jesus, let me read you your destiny. You are going to suffer what I've suffered. Shame. And I said to the destiny thief, in the name of Jesus, your days are over with me. You are not changing my destiny again. Okay? And I looked and I felt a shift. Whoosh! Destiny thief was gone. Now, then, most important part, and these aren't frameworks. I stood back. I draw back my inheritance. I cool down the full, call down the full scroll of my birthright. And I decree that I will be a leader amongst great men. That's my assignment. Within 24 hours, gone. And I went, 24, that's quick business. Let me tell you, when I took back my crown, within 24 hours, that guy was exited. When I took back my sword, demon lips was demonized out. These aren't frameworks. These are real powers. They're not frameworks. Don't take these as frameworks. And I remember Daryl once said to me, you're going to go to work and you're going to read scripture. I was so excited. And I went to work, and we have a plaque which is commemorated to the Prime Minister. And I started reading scripture. And I had my hand on the plaque, and I started reading Isaiah 61. For the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Felt great, powerful. Isaiah 55, arise and shine. My boss comes up to me. She goes, are you okay? And I went, I'm fine. I'm huge in the Spirit. And I go, and I decrease the kingdom over my whole building. Within, 4 hours, I was demoted. And I go to myself, oh, season shift. Man, it's going to hurt. I've done Destiny Thief. I've done the crown. I've done. And I remember I went back. 6 weeks later, I was in pity party again. Roller coaster ride. Come for the ride. It's a free ticket. You may not get off. Stir your emotions up. Start to believe them. And I remember crossing the road and the Holy Spirit said to me, do you remember 6 weeks ago you put your hand on that plaque and you decreed this building for the Lord? You gave up your authority. And you gave your authority up because you were demoted. Take it back. I just crossed the road and And I felt stripes just go onto my shoulders. Within the same week, I was promoted twice as high. And I go to myself, the spirit realm is real. Shh. Goodbye, destiny thief. Call down your scroll. Less land and I'm done. When God is silent, oh, I hear this all the time. Such an injustice. Chris Valentin's got a great message. Go for it. It's good. I really mean that. Because he says when God is silent, when God was speaking, he was creating the world. But when he was silent, he was fashioning and forming humans. So when he's silent, he's doing much more. That's a good word. Go for it. But we're a prophetic church. And you know, we love words. And when there's nothing, it's like... Come on, we thrive on it. Like I can get up to Geordie. And when it's silent, it's like, the number you have called is disconnected. Okay, I'm just going to wrap up. Let me just read this out and I'll close. God's trying to get your attention in this season of silence. What do you have to learn from Him? Let me tell you, in these seasons of silence for me, I don't grow in the seasons of thriving encounters. I grow in the silence. When He teaches me stuff, and it's in my consciousness. It's not in my subconscious or unconscious. It's in my consciousness. You know what that means? I'm learning like a baby. I don't like it. I don't like this learning. I'm trying to give you a scroll. But I'm creating it. And you don't like it. And in this silence, I'm causing you to have a soul. And He's infusing the learning in you. And when He infuses that learning in you, it's yours to keep. And scrolls are being written and imparted into your spirit during these seasons. You know why? Get ready for their execution in the next season. Get ready for their execution in the next season. And on closing, remember your past deliverance and victories. Drink them in. We've talked about your words frame your worlds. This is what I hate the most. God's silent. But the enemy's not. Have you noticed that? He's not silent. Shut the enemy up. And let me close with this. I'm going to close with scripture. Revelation 8. God does more when you assume He's not speaking. I'm going to break some myths. Oh, get this one out of your heads. God is not a spectator. He's not sitting in heaven watching. And you are not alone. He cares for you. He's proactive. And He's extremely powerful. Now, silence doesn't indicate God is not working. God's kingdom is in full force. So in the name of Jesus, I release clarity, guidance, and direction, and new scrolls to be released. And when He opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven for about half an hour. And I saw the seven angels who stand before God, and this is what I love. And seven trumpets were given to them. God gave seven trumpets. What do you want? He gave them seven trumpets. Don't you love that? He gave them a trumpet. You don't think of that, do you? Some of you are going to get trumpets to decree a new season. And another angel who had a golden censer stood at the altar. He was given much incense to offer up with the prayers of all God's people. And on the golden altar in front of the throne, and the Father could smell the incense, the smoke of the incense together with all the prayers of the people went up before God from the angel's hands. Then the angel took the censer and filled it with fire from the altar and hurled it on earth and came peals of thunder, rumblings, flashes of lightning and earthquake. Do you want to know what it sounds like before it's silent or what happens after the silence? Trumpets. This one's about a decree of judgment, but when there's silence, you stop heaven.
Don't think God's silent. He's getting ready for trumpets to be blown. And the incense, that's the storm you want to be in. Lightning and rumblings. I think I'm done.
Isn't that just an amazing message? It was so full, so much in there. Just gonna ask. There was so much in there, and I just want to just with regards to what Pete was saying, you know, going through things and going back, and you might receive this, and you might receive that, and you might just to let you guys know, if you don't receive everything tonight, that's okay. This is a journey, and what Pete's been sharing is a journey of his world. And the way that God doesn't do everything in one night, but he can certainly do quite a lot in one night. And I really believe that he did quite a lot in one night in all of us. And I really believe that even over the next little while, and even this evening, I believe that people will probably, when you're in your bed at night, I really believe that the Holy Spirit will probably take you on the journeys of crown restoration, of the sword restoration, of the activation of the scroll. Even tonight in your bed. And I just want to thank you so much, Pete. I just really feel that was just such an incredible word. And we're gonna have the worship team come and just, I just really feel like that was for the ministry team as well. So we're not gonna necessarily have the ministry team up ministering right now. But what I do want to do is, as the team just, they're about to lead us in some worship, but just before they do that, they just start to play in the background. I'm going to ask Pete to come up. There's one point specifically that I felt just carried so much weight, and I'd really love him to just walk us, and all of you probably know which one I'm talking about, but it was when we had partnered and we were speaking words and the negativity that we had partnered with regards to how many people felt the weight on that when he was, and I really want Pete to just walk us through, just as the team start to play in the background, just that was for someone right there, that's good, it's a panoramic, a similar activation, or I don't want to even call it an activation, just a similar walk, as he walked through that with the Holy Spirit for us today, because I'd really like that too. Is everyone with me? So let's just invite him to come and do that.
Well, okay. So I want you to, just as we walk through that, we're going to get the music going, if you guys could start. What's really important here, it's really important to step back into your dream. That's the most important thing here, is to step back in it. So you bring that dream up to the surface, bring it to your consciousness. And even if there's, don't worry if there's pain, just bring back the thing that makes you come alive. The thing that I was born for. The thing that I was created for. It's a thing that Papa loves watching you do. And you don't even know he's watching. And he's just gazing. He's gazing at you, thinking about it. And doing it. And just bring that dream, bring that passion up and step into it. And just feel the emotions of it, or the thoughts. And I speak to any stronghold right now that is attempting to abort this. I speak to any stronghold. Any unclean thought, any shame of the flesh that's preventing this destiny from being birthed. And I speak, and this is going to be a pregnancy for us. It's going to be lodged into our womb deep. It's not going to take 9 months. And just take that place, that dream. Father God, just don't have to repeat, just follow me. Father God, I'm sorry that I've used my words. I'm sorry that I've even wasted energy thinking about it. And I'm sorry that I've used my emotions to partner and to abort your desire, Papa. That's your desire, Papa. It's not my desire. It's your desire. And I repent, Dad. I repent for not believing you, for not carrying it. And I renounce the words that I spoke into the spirit realm. And just repeat, I renounce the words, the negative words that speak against my destiny, that speak against my nature that was birthed on the cross, that was born on the cross. I retract those words that I'm a failure. I retract those words that I'm good for nothing. I retract those words that this won't happen to me. I retract unbelief. I retract doubt. I retract anxiety and fear. And I speak to the spirit realm and I command you, I revoke and I renounce all power of my words right now. Every contract that I have made, Kira Labasia, I cancel the assignment I have made, and I cancel any assignment that's been made against me. Made against me or my family. And I revoke that assignment in the name of Jesus. I cancel that assignment. And you know what that assignment is, guys, out there. It's what's coming against you that is now cancelled. And I release my hands to heaven. And Papa, I ask for the full force of my inheritance. You receive your inheritance. You receive your birthright. And you hold it. Wait till you feel it. It's in your hand. There's so much weight. This is your baby. This is what I was made for. And you take what's in these hands, and before we steal it into our spirit, you show it to the world. This is who I am. I am Papa's son. I am not of you anymore. And I lift my hands to heaven and say, Papa, are you proud of this? Are you proud of this? And you remember those eyes? Let them burn. Receive those burning eyes. This is the best thing that's ever happened. This is the best. And take that gift, take that inheritance, and seal it into your spirit. Breathe it in. And let out the old. This is a new day. This is a new day. This is a shift. Do you hear that? Freedom! A destiny thief. You've lost your job. I've just served you, noticed. And Papa, I welcome your angels on assignment for me.
Just keep receiving. The meeting is officially finished, so bless you. If you need to go, thank you so much. We look forward to seeing you next week. But we're just going to stay here and just worship for a while. Thanks, Pete. That was awesome.
And Safe in